Okay, good morning, everybody, and welcome to the 15-Minute Mission Podcast. Remember, there is no video. Today, we are dealing with three items for 15 minutes. So we are going to first take care of the bathroom and that mission. Then we're going into the office, and then we're going to talk about the office control journal. So 15 minutes on the clock, and let's go into the bathroom. Now you're going to have to deal, I believe my dryer is still on, so hopefully that doesn't do too much for this. In the bathroom today, we are going to tackle the ceiling. You know what? Let's just turn this off for right now. Oh, you know what? It's all done, and I just made 35 cents. No, it is not all done. It is almost done. So, okay. We are going to be dealing with the ceiling and dusting the ceiling fan, and stuff like that. If you don't have an exhaust fan or vent in your bathroom, then we're going to look at the light fixture. So, bathroom ceilings, they're tall, right? We have two different ways that we can tackle these things. We can either get our vacuum cleaner out, which I am not going to do because, well, then you can't hear me. Or you can do what I'm doing and use a broom with a rag on the top. So that is what we're going to do today. I just have my sweeper, my Swiffer that I have, and I'm just going to put a rag on the top, and then we are going to get the ceilings. So here we go. I really like this week's because I don't think we talk enough about the office control journal or what's going on in the office. And definitely we don't get the tops of our ceilings with the cobwebs enough. Now, in my bathroom, and it actually came up with a client this week, I have a part in my bathroom by my shower that the top part of the shower is not tiled. So the top part of the shower can get yucky. So how do we deal with that? Well, what I do is, let's make sure the computer doesn't fall in the sink, is once a week I go through and I wipe that down. As I'm taking a shower, I just wipe it down. So that keeps that looking nice. So light fixture is wiped down. I need to take care of the vent because, well, that's yucky. So let's take care of the exhaust fan. Once again, just using, you know what, I think I'm going to come back in for the exhaust fan using my vacuum. So I will do that later. Okay, I am going to get the dryer back moving. And now we're going to go deal with the office. I do not have an office. I wish I did. I should, because I work from home. So what you're going to do in your office is today you're going to look on the left side of your computer. What needs to be taken care of there? Is there some filing that needs to be done? Let's get it filed. If there is too much filing to tackle in what's left of our 15 minutes, then make sure that you pick a day. I do it on Thursday, where you tackle any filing that you need to do. So that way you keep up with it. 15 minutes dealing with the filing, not a bad thing to do every Friday. And then you keep up with it. Because if you don't keep up with it, you end up with stacks. I do have a series of videos linking you to dealing with paperwork. So that might be a good one to check out. I believe it is a 5-part series dealing with paperwork and how to handle the paper clutter. It comes up obviously when we hit October's habit of the month. So that is one that goes there. I just am getting myself some water because it's hot. And not just because it's hot, but because I need some water. So maybe there are also... Something doesn't smell right in there. Oh, I think I need to replace the baking soda. Okay. Sorry. Off tangent. Okay. So dealing with our office desk, there may be some other knickknacks there. Take a look at them. Do you love them? If you do, dust them off. Keep them there. If you don't love them, then gift them to somebody who will love them. Donate them to somebody who will love them. And move on from there. Take a look at your pencils. Take a look at everything else that's on the left side of your desk. What needs to happen there? I love the little wire racks that you can get from the Dollar Tree to help organize. We are not going in the desk today. You are just tackling on the left side of your computer. Now, if your computer sits on the left side of the desk, well, hey, let's talk about the office control journal now. This is your work control journal that you are going to use every day at work. Moms, stay-at-home moms, you need it too. Because we have things we need to do. Work-at-home moms, work-at-home dads, stay-at-home dads. This applies to you too. So you want to look at what do I need to do in the morning and just start writing it down. You don't necessarily need to put it in your control journal right now if you need to organize it, but what do I need to do in the morning? For me, we start with the at-home morning routine, right? So I make the bed, swish and swipe, reboot the laundry, get your sack up, get dressed to shoes, hair and face, 5-minute room rescue, 2-minute hotspot drill, open the blinds, have breakfast, check the calendar. Check the calendar also then leads me into my work control journal. So I will revisit that. Have breakfast, do the dishes, ready to go. If I need to do the weekly home blessing, like today, then that gets done. Office control journal starts now. What is the first thing that I do? Well, if you're going to an office, it may be to make coffee. If you work at home, it still may be to make coffee. For me, it is make tea. In these hot months, I already have my iced tea lattes or iced tea. I've been drinking this wonderful blueberry tea that I make the day before because I will drink all of it that day. So then I started off going right away in the morning so it can cool and I can get it in its container. So I start there. Then it's boot up the computer. Take a look at the emails. Are there any that I need to return? Phone calls, any that I need to return? This goes for home and for work. What is on the calendar? Do I have sessions that day? So Tuesday and Wednesday, I veer off of it because I have early sessions. So other stuff happens after those early sessions. Then it's, you know, returning emails, checking emails, returning phone calls. Do I need to make phone calls? Do I need to make phone calls regarding home? Do I need to schedule appointments? What is written down in the calendar? That is why last Friday of the month, it is so important to get your calendar set up for the next month. It is important to revisit that calendar every desk day, so Friday, Thursday, whatever day you've decided, to make sure that all calendars are synced so you don't miss something important. Back to the work control journal. Write everything down that you do in the morning to get yourself ready for the day. Make the coffee, return the phone calls, make your list of phone calls you need to do. Write down your three goals for the day. You can have three work goals, three home goals if they're separate. You know, so like if you're going to work, okay, I need to work on this report. I need to do this and I need to do that. Start with your three. Write, you know, your three goals, then have your daily. I'm not going to get into that too much because that's how I do things. I have my daily notebook and then I also have my general that works for every single day. You've seen that before. So after I've done that, are there meetings that I have to go to today? Are there events that are going on today? All this goes down to check it, look at it. Does not have to be written down in order. List the steps, then take 5 minutes, put it down in order, and either start a separate office control journal or put it in with your regular control journal for office. So after we get that settled, you put it in order and you get it in there. For the rest of the week, we are going to deal with the afternoon and the evening. Matter of fact, I'm going to cover afternoon here. And then before you go home. And then what happens throughout the week. So we will deal with all of that to have your office control journal. Make sure you put down any important phone numbers. Just like we have the important section in our control journal with your insurance information, emergency contacts, water shut off, stuff like that. You need that for your work as well. And this just helps with, you know, getting ready for the day. Now, stay-at-home parents, why do you need this? You stay at home. Well, it's simple. Doctor's appointments, activities, Girl Scouts, Boy Scouts, or Scouts, if you're in the UK. Scout meetings, you have those. Stuff that happens that is not part of the routines is done with work. Are you doing homeschooling? That is work. Getting your lesson plan set out, figuring out what's going on throughout the week. Giuseppe is on break right now, but school is starting, so we are working on flashcards. He has his notebook. We are reading. We are doing all that stuff so his mind stays active and doesn't start melting due to the summer. That is part of the work control journal. That is part of my work day. For me, sessions, flight plans, stuff like that. That also starts dealing with the throughout the week plan, which I'll get to in 3 days. So, including today. Once your bathroom is done, once the side of the computer is done, take a couple minutes, write down your work control journal morning routine. You know, it may be different when you're going to work. Okay, so you're making coffee, you're returning emails, you're checking your progress from the day before. What needs to get done, you know, finish up from the day before. There may be meetings, you may have to check with your supervisor, take a look at what you need to accomplish that day. Start off with a clear head, start off with a clear mind, and know that you will get things done item by item by item. So it all depends upon how you work. You may have to look at your budgets. You may have to look at weekly appointments, whatever it is. Control journal, office, just as important as it is for home. If you work at home, set a starting point for your day. What time do you start? For me, 7. I start at 7 every single day, get it done. Then some, you know, I have appointments then at 7:20, some days then at 7:30. And then I can keep rolling into the other things. So look at your week. How does it happen? Set a starting point. And every day, that is what time you're working from home, you start your office hours. No work for the house gets done for that time. Keep it for work hours. Obviously, if you're going to take a break, take a break. Maybe you can reboot the laundry then, but I would suggest not. I would suggest keeping work and home totally separate, because then you're in the office mindset. So that is your 15-minute mission for the day. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you tomorrow.